Now we will continue the rest of case taking. When inquiring children, the following should be sought about: how this child would be at home, whether the child is stable, whether the child jumps, runs and shouts continuously, being unstable and ever changing, whether the child is adamant, fastidious, easily crying, how the child behaves when his belongings are taken away, whether interested in studies, whether interested in games and sports, how the child behaves with elders and other children and new persons, whether the child has tendency to hurt other children physically during play, whether the child has a tendency to abuse or swear, whether he has sound sleep or not, screams and cries in sleep, grinds teeth in sleep, and whether the child has a tendency for sleepwalking, whether the child can identify his friends immediately after waking up, how this child takes food, whether the child likes and continues to play in water, whether the child has tendency to lie, steal money, roam about in streets, etc. Fourth, the following questionnaire may be useful when taking the disease of middle-aged persons. The volunteer should inquire about whether he or she is continuing the same job. What is his opinion about profession? Whether he has a tendency of changing his job, profession, houses, articles, properties frequently. Whether he has sound sleep. Whether he dreams. If so, the kind of dreams. Whether he has nocturnal emissions. Whether he has any bad habit of masturbation. Whether he has a tendency of prostitution. Whether he suffered from any sexually transmitted disease. If so, the kind of treatment he received. Whether he has affectionate towards children, relatives and friends. How he behaves with children, friends and relatives. Whether he has any love affair and had suffering. Whether he has suffered from any betrayal and other details. 5. When unmarried women come for treatment, details of menses should be recorded. Details about whether they suffer from any psychological disturbances during periods should be collected. Their interests about general reading, periodicals and journals and movies should also be inquired. 6. The following aspects may be considered while taking the case sheet of married woman: how she is received by husband and in-laws, how she responds to them, whether she has love and affection for her husband and in-laws, whether she has regular periods, details about menstrual disturbances if any, details of suffering before, during and after pregnancy, number of pregnancies, abortions, miscarriages if any, and reasons thereof and treatment undergone, whether using any medicine for preponement or postponement of menses. 7. When elderly persons come for treatment, the following details are to be collected: how they are treated by family members, how they respond, react to family members' behavior, whether they are facing any difficulties and sufferings, etc. 8. The following details needed to be collected from patients of all ages, whether he or she has hatred, jealousy, suspicion, vengeance, etc. Whether he can mingle with new persons easily, whether he has any inhibition for taking part in group activity. The case-taking volunteer should keep in mind that healthy person has a peaceful mind and any deviation is a symptom of disease. It should also be remembered that all symptoms constitute the true form of the disease. Volunteer should give prominence to such symptoms while taking the case. Fifth phase. In this phase, the modalities of symptoms shall be recorded. To elicit information, the following questionnaire may be useful. We should inquire whether symptoms aggravated or ameliorate when exposed to hot sun, cool breeze, during day, night, morning, mid-noon, afternoon, evening, midnight, after exposure to rain, before lunch, after lunch, when he is hungry, while he is watching a movie, while he is working, while he is in shopping, when he goes on journey by bus, train, by hot water application, cold water application, by hot drinks, cold drinks, before, during, after sleep, before, during, after sex, when he goes into a mob group, when exposed to pungent smell, on hearing big sounds, on watching quarrels, on exposure to intense light, when he goes into closed room, open eye, when he covers himself with bed sheet, when exposed to fan eye, after taking bath in sea water, river water, after cool water bath, hot water bath, after wearing, removing clothes, when he wears tight clothes, when he moves, when he lies down without movement, when he bends forward, when he bends backward, when he lies on his back, when he lies on his stomach, when he lies down sideways, when he is sitting, when he is walking around, when he touch about a wound, when pressure is applied, when tight bandage is applied, when he is speaking to others, when others are speaking to him, when others wish him, when others do not wish him, before, after, during urination, before, after, during menses, before, after, menstrual bleeding commences, during menstruation, at the time of cessation of menstruation flow, after menstruation ceases, during pregnancy, when he or she making food, when the climate changes, etc. Then we should inquire the patient's preferences for food. We need to know which type of foods he likes the most, which he dislikes, whether he likes sweet, salt, sour, hot, etc. We should also learn from the patient which type of food he consumes most and how his symptoms change after taking food. Sixth phase, medical history of the family. In this step, we should record the past medical history of the patient's family. We should inquire about the health of his parents, brothers, sisters, paternal, maternal uncles, aunts, and grandparents. We should inquire whether any of the family members suffered in the past from diseases like TB, cancer, paralysis, heart diseases, etc. Whether anybody suffered from insanity, whether there were instances of sudden death or suicide, whether anybody had tendency to get addicted to drugs, etc., and whether anybody had a tendency to murder and such other details. Tomorrow we will continue the remainder lesson of case taking. Lokah samasta sukhino bhavanto, lokah samasta sukhino bhavanto, lokah samasta sukhino bhavanto. Om shanti shanti shanti.